Yeah, brother. So here it is, man. I think it's been, what?
Yeah, you ain't playing this shit. This is crazy. Shout out to my cultivation. Hey, this is a big difference, man.
Oh, huge.
5 weeks ago?
Yeah. Check out this one.
I can smell it already.
Oh, dude. Look at this. Right here, bro.
That smells phenomenal.
Yeah. So, I mean, we're pretty much, you know, we're right at the finish line right here. So
it was like this tall when I came here last. Now they up there.
Yeah.
Here at Gasco, we focus on exotic strains. We like to do our own breeding. Like the beer and wine industry, you're always going to have craft. So for us, we believe we are more of a craft cannabis type of brand. But now I got a package of squad. It won't be long before we back on the job. Here's your Kush Co live. Look what real niggas do for the cost. One call, we get crowd genetics involved. Second call, I mean I want the world tapped in. Third call, I hit them like it's time to evolve. Showing love to everybody that be growing. So you see like each one that's like numbered here?
Yeah.
That's all its individual pheno. So early on, right before we went into flowering, we took 5 cuts off of every single pheno where we store it somewhere else. And we basically flower everything else out here. And depending on how everything comes out is what we're gonna keep around. And after the final taste test, try everything out. How long's the high last, the taste, the flavor.
A little R&D.
You know, yeah, exactly, bro. And then, you know, once we find it, all right, let's run a whole row of
blow
this.
Blow a whole room up. Yeah, you know what it is.
That's it.
Let's go.
I mean, look at this. This motherfucker's a keeper, bro. All day, you know? Like, all day.
All day long, yeah.
That's a yuck mouth culotto back cross, so.
He's yet to be named, man. He's a brand new creation, man. You know what I mean? We talking to the man who's making it all happen.
Hey, man.
I just need to be around for the taste testing. Period. Yeah. I want to be involved.
As far as popularity, we really got our name out there pretty quick. I think the Bay Area was kind of known for exotics. And I feel like we're one of the brands in LA to bring exotics, you know, and be known for doing exotics here in LA.
I mean, bro, you could throw a fucking bottle cap in here, dude, and hit a keeper, bro. I like the look on this one, but I like the yield on that motherfucker. Uh-huh. I mean, we got to see how that one finishes out. Take this for example, bro. Same exact cross.
Yeah, that one.
Completely
right there.
Different pheno. So you would never know that it was the exact same genetics.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's why it's so important, this large scale, you know, pheno hunting, because you got to pick and choose. You got like brothers and sisters. You guys all look alike, but you don't look exactly alike.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You guys have traits, but you're different. So it's your own identity. Yeah. So it's the same strain, same genetics, same parents, but you know, different phenos. The research and development that goes into these new strains that we are selecting and finding amongst hundreds of already elites, we're grabbing the elite of the elite. And that's why Gasco stands out amongst all the other companies.
So I think that's one big misconception, is they think it's easy money. It's not, it's hard work and it's earned.
So those 4 trays there, those 4 trays back, that was all straight directly from seed. And I mean, as you can see, you know, compared to everything else in the room, I mean, there's keepers on keepers, you know what I mean? So
most time you buy seeds and you're going to get some Hermes and stuff, but we do all the R&D to where we're not going to release something where we have Hermes in the mix.
There's all the yuck mouth culotto, you know, the famous yuck mouth culotto strain. You know, this is where all this is grown. This is the only facility in the world that this strain's grown out of. This isn't grown anywhere else. It's just grown directly out of here.
You feel like this is one of the ones that kind of popped it off?
Oh, this one's been popping off, bro. Like, this has always been a crowd favorite.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And right here, dog, your baby. Yeah, this is it, bro.
I'm playing with me.
Yeah, this is the Mac tonight.
Roll the Mac tonight in the paper plane. This life's a game, you gotta pay to play. You know how the saying goes, everything costs. Chalk on the track, I'm about to rip it like a chainsaw.
Man, I work hard on God, no days off.
Yup, yup. This strain, you got to take it to that full day 70, and then it'll pretty much be like solid purple, you know?
It's evolving all the way to the end.
Yeah, all the way to the end, bro, exactly. Dude, the leaf to bud ratio is just, I mean, it's kind of like a grower's dream, because, you know, the trim job on it, just snip, snip, snip. There's like no, you see there's no leaf on it. It's all just bud. It's kind of fucking cool, man, because we ended up breeding with this Mac tonight and crossing it with the culotto, creating like the 42 Hellcat, and then back crossing that to the yuck mouth culotto. We were able to, you know, breed the mutants out of it.
Yeah.
To where now, like, all those phenos over there is just nothing but fire, bro. You know, you just breed the fire with the fire on the fire, and you get nothing but fire.
Come on, man, simple math, man. Yeah. Anybody can understand that one. Love this one to this day, my favorite strain. Best weed I smoke, like, consistently. I can smoke it all the time. I never get tired of it. And it's the shit. I love it.
Yeah, so every step that we've taken during this process has led to this right here. So, I mean, right now we're ready to pretty much pull this stuff down. I mean, it's got another 5 days, but you can see the exact direction that, I mean, it's going in, and it's obviously fire.
I want to take some home today. I know it's not ready yet.
Yeah.
It looks like it's looking great. Best strains in the world, bro. I've been saying it, Gasco.
That's
man.
It.
Yes,
thank
sir.
You.
Here at Gasco, we create our own strains, we create our own strain names, and I think that's what truly makes us exotic, you know, because we do our own breeding, we have our own genetics, we have a seed company, the Vault Seed Bank as well. So I think we have enough strains and enough know-how to where we can become a brand that's nationally recognized. We want to be known to be what we are, and that's badass growers that grow some of the best fucking weed in the world.
We got the gay guys in the building.
Some of the most heavily requested motherfuckers is everywhere we go. We're the culotto. How can we get the culotto?
The thumbtastics of the game, man. Gasco, the Vault Seed Bank is in the motherfucking building.
These the first guys that ever in this cannabis culture that approached me with some shit that I was like, whoa. When that shit reminded me like of some shit up top, but better. Like they outdid up top. Like on some shit, like, oh, y'all fucking the game. I need to be behind this. So we link up, man, and we've been fucked with it for like 3.5 years, damn near 4 years.
How the fuck y'all get that color and that crystallized like that, man? Y'all should look very different from a lot of, we go to a lot of weed events.
Facts.
Of course, that's why y'all win all these awards. You know, that's why y'all win a lot of awards, but what is the first thing your point of attack when y'all be making these strands? Y'all some award-winning motherfuckers.
You know, we put in the work, bro. We put in the work for the selection, and we do, like, the way we breed is very strategic on, like, the type of traits that we're looking for when we breed, and then when we pheno select, we're even more, like, rigorous on, like, the R&D, because we'll run hundreds, and then we choose one. Like the Yuck Mouth Culotto, ran hundreds.
And bring something new to the table. These dudes are bringing shit new to, everybody got gelato.
And don't just bring a new bag to the table. Like, look, dude, I got a graphic designer who can bust these things out 100 a month, you know what I mean? But bring a new strain to the table. A new strain takes 9 months to create before you can get it in circulation to where you're even in a position to get it in bags. Well, so these are like the potential.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly. There's the 42 Hellcat crossed with the Yuck Mouth Culotto number 31.
Oh my fucking God. Ooh, look at the swole up on this one.
That was definitely one of the.
This hard body karate.
Must got that OG feel to it.
Shit.
The Terps.
That's
Terps.
My Lord.
Got that glitz.
That's hardball. That's that hardball. I ain't seen him with no hardball, nigga. That's that hardball, bro.
Bro, we wouldn't cross anything other than anything with our best strain. The best strain was the Yuck Mouth Culotto. Of course, we're gonna breed with that.
Award-winning strain.
We're gonna breed with that shit.
When I first met y'all blew my mind with y'all strands, man. Now y'all doing it again, bro. It's like a fucking deja vu. It's a deja vu.
I'm talking about, this is when you go to Costco and just put about $700 in your tank.
All of our phenos are super fucking fire, so we're able to grow again, get our phenos, so everything's fire. So we could do these selections, you know?
We coming to a motherfucking dispensary near you. We coming to a motherfucking cannabis club near you. We coming to a motherfucking health and wealth center near you, motherfucker. Now, No more bootlegging, nigga. We in the clubs, you bitch.
We'll let you know the release date when these are coming. We got another round coming down, so we're gonna let you know where this is all gonna be dropping. You know what I mean? Yuck Mouth's gonna pull up, DEMRICK's gonna pull up, the whole squad gonna pull up. It's gonna be a hell of a fucking day, bro. I'm telling legendary shit.
Tap in with the kids, man, right here. Green Thumb, motherfucking Thumbtastic, baby. Tap in, gas cold is a motherfucking no-go.
No
Yuck Mouth said it, you bitch. Yada-da, boy!
I mean, I think for us, we kind of blew up really quickly from when we started. I think we really made the right moves initially. One of the few brands in the smoke box and stuff like that. So we see us as more of really an urban lifestyle. And I do see a lot of potential with that. We are planning on doing product launches and strain releases and those types of things. And then eventually, you know, the conventions and bigger events. You gotta always keep moving forward. You gotta always keep looking and trying and creating. You see these large corporations throwing hundreds of millions of dollars, tens of millions of dollars into one license, you know, one cultivation. And yeah, I was a little fearful in the beginning. People that smoke, they know what they're smoking. They know what it is. And so if you're giving me a product that looks subpar, that just happens to be in a fancy bag or jar, you're gonna get found out quick and the word is gonna spread super fast. The corporate side of it is good because we need funding, but it'd be good for those corporations to kind of link up with brands like us.
I kind of feel like they're gonna fuck it up for themselves, how successful they will be. They'll probably be like Bud Light or a Coors Light compared to like a Crafts beer. I can see the commercial companies being like that, you know, where it's that readily available, where it's just, they're not putting out quality product.
I think a lot is changing due to the recreational market. I think we can all work together to create something amazing.
Hopefully by the end of, you know, this whole pheno selection, we are in every store out there, because every store is hitting us up saying, how can we get Gasco in our collective? You know, so that's what we're working on right now.
If it's going down, it's a big day for Gasco, man. It's happening right now. Dr. Green Thumb's dispensary downtown LA. You pull up and get you some of them exclusive Gasco strains. It's going down.
I'm waiting for this motherfucking day, man. This hard work pays the fuck off, man. Number scientists, my G. Number super genetics over here, baby. Gasco or no go, man. All gas, no brakes.
All gas, no brakes.
It's 420, get more money absorbed from me. I'll be raining fire, a storm coming, was born running. Game. Listen, we don't smoke the same.
That gas stuff.
Right here, man. Pushing flame.
And he's still over here dropping new strands, so make sure you guys check out that Mac tonight.
You hit it, now you want to ride, slide with me. Burner got cherry pie twisted, and you don't want to fucking miss it. It's exclusive.
The business side of Gasco, it goes hand in hand with all the marketing that we do. The more you see it out there, the more that you want it. And the more people want it, the higher the demand is, the more stores it's gonna be in, the more readily available it will all be. Gasco is one of the biggest recognized cannabis brands worldwide. It's like a fucking Pepsi, like Coca-Cola. Everybody knows Gasco. You know, one of the things we see the most of on the Gasco IG is, where are you guys at? Where can I get it? But where can I get it?
The demand is definitely there. It's just a matter of planning and strategizing and getting out in those areas.
The people that buy it from us, they buy it from us and they say, we just want to say we can get Gasco. That's all they want. We just want to say we can get it. You know, I don't know. We're doing something right, obviously.
Admiración y respeto por ser. Lo miraba como hermano.
Bro, the text of these motherfuckers is really dumb, man. Like, I really like the density and all that shit. Like, that shit ain't dry, that shit ain't no crunch, no. Like, you can squeeze that shit almost, and that shit gonna flub all the way back up. Yeah.
Creamy cure and shit.
Yeah, real cakey.
For the gas.
We smoking, man. We smoking, man. We gas coat smoking, man. Y'all see my nose sweating. Smoking for sure. My nose ain't sweating because I'm high. It's just smooth. Got a nice taste to it, man. Honestly. Like, if I eat some food and smoke this shit at the same time, it ain't gonna throw off nothing.
I would say our most potent strain is probably the Jade Helm. It was a Hellraiser crossed with a Face on Fire. It was in the 30s. All I know, bro, is that like when people smoke that shit, just one rip, they'd be sweating and they're paranoid, thinking that, you know, somebody's out to get them. You know, like, dude, bro, relax, just weed. I've never seen a strain like that where it just put people down like they took a dab. But you know, the 30 range is like pretty much the highest. I mean, anything like over that, I mean, you're kind of questioning the lab and, you know, the testing and all that. We only want to be putting out good, clean product that's going to pass all testing, no pesticides, no GMO, weird stuff, no heavy metals. No, so you'll never see like any of our stuff coming back testing for any like weird pests or anything.
Yo, today we're here with my man, legendary Yuck Mouth. Hey, thank you, bro.
Oh, thank you. Come on, man.
Appreciate you.
Come on, man. Appreciate you, man.
Yeah, Yuck Mouth has a strain with us. You already know what it is. Yuck Mouth Culado. The legendary Yuck Mouth Culado. This is the first signature strain that we have for Gasco, and it's still the fan favorite, knocking down doors. And the man's here today. He wanted to see how it's coming. This is coming down tomorrow, so.
Oh, shit, coming down tomorrow. Oh, my God. Hold up, this small up, man. Yeah, let me look at the name, man. Man, when he showed me this creation, you know what I mean? This wonderful, magnificent creation of plant. It looked so beautiful, man. It was just all black and purple, dark purple that I ain't never seen since, like, nice. Granddaddy Purple, like the Bay Area. I come from the Bay, so Granddaddy Purple had that whole Granddaddy Purple look, but the yield was crazy. It was a big-ass super bud. When you smoke something and it make your face sweat, you know what I mean? That's some gas, man, period. You're coughing and your face starts sweating, your forehead, you gotta wipe down. That's some gas, bro, period. So as soon as I smoked, the instant sweat, instant cough of belly, I knew we had one, man. So I'm like, yo, let's do it, bro.
You took first place, Kushstock, Dabathon.
So two awards later,
yeah,
you know what I mean? We still out here.
Anything we enter this motherfucker and it's taking it. With a product like this, I mean, there's not a single store that doesn't want us in their club.
And the thing
I like, shit on the streets right now, so.
You guys genetically made this from the seed on up.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean?
That's the only way.
Made your own strength. A lot of shit is black label, though. Mm-hmm. Black label, white label, green label, whatever you want to call it.
Yep.
They take another strand and just put a different name on it, or a colorful bag on it, but it's the same strand being sold.
Right.
This is not.
This is the only facility that this strain is created.
Period.
So if it didn't come directly from Gasco, it is not Yuck Mouth Culado. This is the only housing where Yuck Mouth Culado is cultivated in.
This is a one of one.
It's all right here. You can see it. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. That's it. Yuck Mouth Culado. There's not another one like it.
We do have some, you know, potentials of stuff that we've crossed, and we kind of did a pretty big pheno hunt where we were able to find, you know, two or three different strains. But we're really looking for like that unicorn strain, you know, that one where it's just like, oh shit, what is this? I gotta try it, you know, I gotta smoke it and see what's up, you know.
The pheno hunt, it went immaculate, no problems all the way through. If you looked at everything looked like a keeper. It looked like it would be the most amazing thing in anybody's grow. We decided to just select one out of the hundreds that we did run. It's always a success if you pull one out of there. Of course, we're looking for more. Of course, we want to get 5, 7 in a perfect world, but we pulled one great one out of there. When we shot everything to DEMRICK, shot it to Yuck, shot it to Be Real. When everybody went ahead and tried it, it kept coming back. The number two jar. And the number two jar was the number 65 of the 42 Hellcat crossed with the Yuck Mouth Culado. And that's the one we're bringing to you today. We're introducing to you Woolly on the Moon. This is the one we were just talking about. This is the Woolly on the Moon. Everybody's going to the fucking moon, but who's the first motherfuckers to put a woolly on the moon?
On the moon, gas cold.
Gas
no,
cold,
no,
baby.
Man.
Let's go.
Yeah, know where it come from, man. Know the originators, not the haters. It is.
Right here, baby, right here. Every purchase, $1 is donated to the Woolly to the Moon Foundation, where we will teleport a fucking woolly directly to the moon through SpaceX. With your help, we can put a woolly on the moon, save world hunger, world peace, by putting a woolly on the moon. And then the fact, I mean, the shit gets you high as fuck, you know, it's gonna put you on the moon. I mean, this one's very heavy, sedating. It's great nighttime smoke, real couch lock. Indica dominant hybrid.
All tens, my friend.
All tens. All tens.
Yes, all tens, my all friend. Oh, you squeeze it. All, yeah. all the goodness come out. Little pinch, little squeeze pinch. Ooh. Yes, sir, man. So yeah, we back on another roll, man. This is exotic roll, designer roll, baby. Gas code, man. All designer, baby. Designer fire. Anything you desire, baby.
The terps on that are gonna be crazy when fucking those come out.
That's real green thumb talk. We don't understand that, but yeah, the growers, they understand that.
You know what I mean?
You dig? And gas code, man, y'all blew my mind today, man. It's good to finally see it in person, the behind the scenes.
Yeah, it's been a while. It's been a while.
Yeah, before it's in the
been
bag.
A while. Yeah.
You done stepped it up, you know what I mean? It's a new step up, man. So yeah, just a whole row of culado. That's crazy, bro.
Yeah.
We about to spank they ass, man. Yeah. Coming to a dispensary near you, man. Gas stores are no go, baby. Grown by TBS, baby. And it gotta be the best, you dig? Green Thumbs at its finest, man. Yuck, man, we out this motherfucker, baby. Bye-bye now. Culado, let's go.
At the end of the day, you should be in competition with yourself. Don't be in competition with other people. Be the best that you can do, you know? Like, it's really about you and the plant and what you're putting out. Work with what's in front of you right now and how you can be the best at what you're working with right now and how you can get better and better and better.
Everybody has a job, you know, everybody has a passion in life. If you're lucky enough to find it, you know, I do feel like cannabis is my passion.
I mean, it's just, yeah, it's just an all out lifestyle, man. It's not even like a, it's not even a job. It's just, it's kind of just like what we do. And I don't know, dude, I'd rather fucking work with the plants than go to the club. It's just what I enjoy doing, man. You know what I mean? The plants can't talk back to you. You treat them well, they're gonna treat you well.
You know, a huge sacrifice is with, you know, my family. You know, a lot of time goes into this, a lot of work, a lot of hours. So those are sacrifices we both had to make to get to the point that where we're at right now. You know, we still have a long way to go, but at least now we kind of have a map. We have a blueprint on which direction to go in. As each state goes recreational, we want to have a hand in that state as well. We have a lot of requests on Instagram, and I think that's what's going to separate us, you know. And I do see us going nationwide. I do see us in every state, every shop, as well as our merch, you know, our merchandise. I feel like we have a clean, minimalist logo where you don't even have to like weed, but you might like our clothing. So I feel like sky's the limit for us.
Man, we're talking about some big things, dude. We got some licensing deals going on out in Thailand. One of our boys, he's got one of the only licenses in Thailand. He's taking his whole operation and moving it to Thailand. So we're looking into that. We haven't came to an agreement yet, but we are gonna be branching out, you know, not only nationwide, but we're also gonna be branching out, you know, worldwide, where we have Gasco brand in Thailand.
We're excited for the future. Yeah, we're coming in. We're coming in hot. I love it. I love what we do.
We're gonna get back in the swing of things, start doing the shows again, you know what I mean? Get out in the face of people and drop all that shit and just show love to all the people.